As the government agency responsible for monitoring and inspecting schools in Lagos State, the Office of Education Quality Assurance, led by the Director General, Mrs. Runke Soyombo, has been up to the task of ensuring that schools in the state are running optimally. Recently, officials of the agency, led by the Director General, paid an impromptu monitoring visit to local authority primary school, Akpa Badagry.
What do we call this? Pentagon. Well done. Can we clap for this wonderful thing? What's the fraction going to be? 2/what?
2/5.
2/5. Give me 5, Mari. You're too good. You're too hot. Well done. Okay? Well done. Do we understand now? And what's the fraction of children wearing uniforms to children wearing all the uniforms?
3/5.
Well done. You're so brilliant. Well done.
So I need you to promote a lot of speaking and listening in the school. The more we promote that, then every subject allow our children to read. They can read to you. Develop their confidence. Raise the profile of reading, because that's what Office of Education Quality Assurance is all about. Let every child know how to read. Then it gives them a better platform for the subject.
The head teacher of the school, Mrs. Tawakalitu Balogun, told Education Report on TV that all the shortcomings identified by the quality assurance officers would be looked into.
We've learned a lot of things concerning literacy, numeracy, and other things like that. I will try to work on those things immediately.
According to the Director General, the teachers of local government authority primary school are doing a good job.
There's no doubt about it that these teachers are working their socks off. We've seen very, very good spirit that they have actually shown, because they are trying their best. However, we have identified quite a lot of areas that the government will need to support them on, and that's something I'm taking back today. But at the same time, the children are very lovely.
She also visited Lagos State Model College, Kanko, and there she inspected the school's facilities. Director General also interacted with the students.
As soon as you start your secondary school education, don't forget that you are building your future. Because from that stage, some people you will meet in secondary school will be your lifetime friends. They will make you to become whatever you become. Today, if we ask the governor, His Excellency Governor Akinwumi Ahmadu, that how many people are in his cabinet from his schoolmates in secondary school, I am sure he would have been surrounded by a lot of them. And that's why you must be very, very good with friends, in keeping friends. The only thing is, you must be able to know the boundary. No, I'm not going for that. You must stay focused as a child. Even though you are in secondary school with the girls, but at the same time, you know where the limit is. I don't want to stay with a girl on a one-to-one. I don't want to actually go to where they have been told not to go to.
The principals of the senior and junior schools stated that they are ready to work hand-in-hand with the Office of Education Quality Assurance.
The visit is very important to the growth of our school, in the sense that some areas that we are not even looking at, thinking that maybe they were tiny areas, were highlighted. And by the time we go back to correct these little corrections, definitely it will impact on our performance. More so during the last West African School Certificate Examination, our result moved to a very great high. In fact, we had 90%. But with these corrections, I'm sure that our slogan, which is 100% is achievable, will surely be achieved.
The quality assurance exercise is a very good one because it puts us on a tour, showing us the areas where we need to improve upon, because no matter how good a thing is, there will be room for improvement. So the areas where we still need to make amends have been shown to us. We've been given some guidelines as to achieve this, to become a standard model. Already we are a model school, but according to Ms. Oyombo, with our team, they said there are still some areas where we need to buckle up, where we need to tidy up, and we've noted them down. So the visits, we give a school a facelift, like our library. They told us about library, what we can do, how we can review books, put them on the wall and things like that to make children get interested in reading more.
The quality assurance have been doing their best. Because of the improvement, our teachers, they have been discharging their duties accordingly. Starting from where we started, you can see what the teachers have been doing. They have been allowing our students to at least group discussions. They have been going to their classes. Where necessary, they always correct, give the student notes. Even they have even made the student to be teachers. How? We give them instruction, we give them assignments, and the area they need to touch, they have been doing this. And it is through the help of the quality assurance. Every time this team always visits our schools to ensure that teaching are going on as expected.
According to the Director General, feedback from students is very important.
We saw good practice, particularly with the way books are being annotated. We looked at the books. Clearly, the children are having good coverage of lessons, and the work is appropriately challenging as well. And with the way the teachers have been annotating it, because that is what is going to inform their planning. And in some of the schools that we have visited where teachers are not annotating books enough, well, how do you know the child is performing? So to me, that's why we want to bring teachers here, to actually see the good practice. Because it's not just about the school environment. School environment matters, there's no doubt about that. But at the same time, what goes into the child's book? What is teaching and learning all about? Do you just ask the children? Because in some of the schools that we've been to, where we've seen that children are just copying down notes. You can copy down notes, but what are the textbooks there for? Children can read, teach them, allow them to actually give feedback, because it makes you to know where the child's learning is, where the level is, and what you can actually do as a teacher to support the child.
Some of the students also shared their views with Education Report on TV.
I'm very happy with what has happened in our school today, and they did so much. They went through hostels, books, science lab, maths lab, and so on and so forth. It has really improved our school because our students are very happy about that. We are really, really happy, and we appreciate them a lot because they've improved us.
They tried, they inspect our hostels, did everything, advise us as we are going to face our education and all that. I just thank the school for their cooperation and everything.
Due to the fact that teachers in my school know that inter-quality assurance comes around, that they're going to evaluate and check the things I've done. This is my school, they're always very, very dedicated because we have competent, dedicated, and well-informed teachers. A lot of facilities which we didn't have before, we're going to provide, such as classrooms, better classrooms, and a well-equipped computer lab. Well, the laboratories have been upgraded. Our hostels, which were inadequate before, they have built new hostels. The teachers now have learning aids. They have all the materials they need. So it has really helped improve the quality of education in my school.
In terms of teaching and learning, our teachers are very dedicated. They meet up with their scheme of works by ensuring that the student actively participates in classes. The teachers also help the students in involving in practical areas, like by inputting teaching aids that the student can easily grab through practical means. From practicals for the science students, the teachers has also been of help in these areas as a major part in the sciences. We cannot do without practicals and experiments. The teachers have been of immense importance in this field also.
They've helped us, like, out of their little time, they've visited our school, helped us in different things and others, in a lot of areas.
From Lagos State Model College, Kanko, she went ahead to have a meeting with stakeholders in Badagry, and they deliberated on how to move education in Badagry forward. Indeed, school supervision and monitoring is central to the attainment of qualitative education. It therefore behooves on the schools visited to focus on the key areas highlighted by officials of education quality assurance and work harder in ensuring that their schools continue to meet the standard set by the Lagos State Government. Established in 2010 with the aim of developing the leadership view, capacity and influence of the African youth, Positive Growth Africa recently organized the first edition of the Students' Fortress Conference for students in the Lagos State Education District 1 with the theme, The Road to Success.
Our focus for this conference is to see how do we ensure that students, teachers and the institutions that support them partner together to ensure that we raise champions who will lead Africa to the next level that she requires.
Popular motivational speaker and the managing director, Gemstone Fela Durotoye, did a good job of educating participating students on how to toe the path of success.
Why don't you help me tell the person next to you, if you lead a rough life, you may find it hard and tough to succeed in life. I want you to please say it on my right. If you lead a rough life, you may find it tough to succeed in life. The more you read, the greater your ability to lead. The more you learn, the greater your capacity to earn. The higher you go in your educational accomplishment, chances of earning more.
According to the Director of Administrative and Human Resources, Ministry of Education, who represented the Deputy Governor of Lagos State, Dr. Mrs. Idiat Adebule, programs of this nature will propel the students to do better in the academics and in future become great leaders.
This is a very good initiative in the sense that with the kind of students we have in Lagos State, this kind of initiative will propel them to do better in their academics. It will also propel them to be greater leaders of tomorrow, because what they are learning here is for them to be good leaders, to be those that we're looking forward to tomorrow, to be the savior of Nigeria.
The club is an academic club. The students will mentor one another, and we are building an online, a learning management system where all the students will be on the platform, and we have online tutors supporting them. So we expect to see change in the results in the external examinations. We expect students to learn life and leadership skills through the club, and we expect to see change in behavior.
Education Report on TV spoke to the Director General, Office of Education Quality Assurance, Mrs. Runke Shiyombo, and the Teacher General, Permanent Secretary, Education District 1, Dr. Mrs. Yinka Anyodele. And according to them, the conference will help to positively develop the minds of the students.
The major aim is actually to build the minds of students, going beyond the four walls of schools, going beyond building infrastructure. So we want to ensure that we build the minds in the right way. It is our belief that when we do this, we'll have a total war against examination failure and failure of leadership.
Anything that can inspire our children, anything that can change their attitude, anything that can motivate our children into actually having a brighter future, to me is the best. And today, I mean, leading to success, what we've seen so far has really impacted to a lot of our children, and I'm so proud of all the organizers of this event.
Other guests also shared their views.
People who enlist, we have a chance of improving on even what they learn in the classroom. They have a chance of interacting with other students. They have a chance of being mentored because there will be a tutor for each subject. So they have a chance of improving themselves over and above what they learn in the classroom.
The four things I shared with them, I used the word ROAD, R-O-O-A-D. I said R stands for the realization that they can succeed. The problem with a lot of us is that we are bombarded with negative news. And such news kind of makes us believe that we cannot succeed. So R is saying, I can succeed. That realization that I can succeed, we now go to O. O is objective, which I call setting goals. That if you must succeed, you must set big goals.
For anybody to succeed in life, you have to address the three H. And what are these three H? The heart, the head, and the hand. And so the program that is happening here today, they are addressing the principal one, which is the heart, and that is the mind.
Most of them there are stars. But if we don't tell them, if we don't excite them, they will not go beyond their comfort zone. So this is just an avenue to awaken them, awaken the giant in them.
As for the students, the conference was a life-changing event.
Being here today is a great achievement because I've achieved so many things. Number one, I learned that we need to be determined. When you are determined, you know what to do. Number two, you need to be disciplined. When you are disciplined, number three, you need to be bold. You must not be shy. You must have the boldness. You must have the courage that you can make it in life.
You need to determine what you want to become. And you need discipline to succeed in life. And they have made us know that our future lies in our hands. And we must read hard. Leaders are leaders. And we must learn to earn. As you learn more, you earn more. So I've learned some vital information about my future today.
We were taught the four secrets of success. That is the abbreviation ROAD. That is R stands for realization of your goals. Then O, your objective. Then A, your action plan. That is the association, the people you associate with. Then D, your determination, dedication, and discipline.
Other activities of the day were the unveiling of the Positive Growth Africa logo and the presentation of awards of recognition. The Students' Fortress Conference will indeed build leaders of impeccable character to influence positive growth not only in Nigeria but in the entire world. The latest edition of the Lagos Schools Journal is out. Copies are available for public primary schools at their local government education authorities. Public secondary schools can get theirs at their education districts and private schools at Block 5, Room 2, Alausa Secretariat. You can also read it online at www.lagosschoolsonline.com. Lagos Schools Journal, bringing education to your desk in Lagos State.